Hello all, welcome to the channel Learn Everything Karka Kasarara. In this video, we are going to see about some common tools which are used in welding. Before knowing about the tools, we should be aware of some best practices to be followed in welding shop. First, we have to avoid loose clothing. Second, we have to wear shoes. And third, we have to use hand gloves, goggles, face shield to protect ourselves from sparks. Care should be taken while welding, and there should not be any inflammable material available in the welding shop. And finally, we should not directly see the light rays. First is face shield. It is a tool used to protect the eyes of the welder from the light sparks which is produced during welding, and it is held in hand. And second is goggle. Again, it is used to protect the eyes of welder from light sparks. Next is hand gloves. Since we are dealing with hot metals, it is very essential to protect our hands, so we are using hand gloves. And this is chipping hammer. It is used to remove slags which are formed during welding. So during the process of welding, there is something called a slag which is formed over the welded material. It should be removed. And next is wire brush. It is the final process for cleaning the welded material. Next is tongle. It is used to hold the workpiece. Since the workpiece will be very hot, we cannot handle with bare hands, so it should be handled with tongle. And this is welding rod. It is made of same metal what we are going to weld, and it is coated with a material, and that coating material is used for protecting the hot metals from oxidation. During the process of welding, the metals will be very hot, and that may be reacting with the oxygen present in the atmosphere, which will create oxidation process. This coated material will act as a protective layer which avoids oxidation, and that is known as slag. And this is known as electrode holder, in which we'll be holding the welding rod. It is connected with orange cable, and this is the welding machine. Here you can see two cables. One is orange, which is positive, and second is black, which is negative. This black cable is grounded to earth, and it is connected to the welding table. And this orange cable, obviously it is connected to the electrode holder. And once after fixing the welding rod in the electrode holder, this is how we have to initiate the process of welding. It is known as arc welding. In addition to the tools used in arc welding, we have some other tools in gas welding also. This is known as cylinder key. It is used for adjusting the flow of oxygen in oxygen cylinder. This is spark lighter, which is used for initiating the ignition process. Here you can see two cylinders. The black one is for oxygen. It is connected to blue tube, and the green container is known as acetylene generator. It is used for producing acetylene, and it is connected to orange color tube. And through this nozzle, the two gases will be mixed, and it is being allowed to create a flame. As I mentioned, blue is for oxygen, and maroon or orange is for acetylene. And this is known as filler rod. In case of arc welding, we have used welding rod, whereas in case of gas welding, we will be using filler rod. Thick metal plates will be welded using arc welding, and thin metal plates will be welded using gas welding. That is one difference between arc welding and gas welding, and again, the working of arc and gas welding is completely different. But along with that, we have thin metal plates for gas welding, and if you want to weld thick metal plates, you have to go for arc welding. So this is all about the basic tools to be used in welding. I hope you have got some information related to the basic tools to be used in welding. I'll meet you in the next video with a new content. Thank you for watching.